Hello everyone, welcome to our 7th lecture, and this lecture is based on Clark diagram for two machine series reactant system, a graphical representation. In last lecture we have seen cut and dry process. Now this is our second method, graphical representation using Clark diagram. Okay, the scientist Miss Clark has demonstration this Clark diagram, cut and dry process. There is more many complications and no clarity, no exact value of that steady state stability we can get from cut and dry process. It is illustrative process and it is trial and error process, so definitely we are not getting exact value. So Miss Clark has advised this graphical representation. So according to this by the honor the representation is called as Clark diagram. Now we'll see Clark diagram for two machine series reactors system, graphical representation. The cut and dry process illustrated lecture 6 can be avoided through use of graphical construction devised by Miss Clark. The construction will be discussed now. Okay, again we are considering two machine system without losses. So without losses means we are considering only pure reactances x1 xn x2, two machine system. This is first machine and this is second machine. Okay, this is internal voltage of first machine, terminal voltage of first machine, terminal voltage of second machine, internal voltage of second machine. Okay, this you know, P is equal to E1 into E2 by x into sine of del. When del is equal to 90 degree, when del is equal to 90 degree, then this is our P max at del is equal to 90 degrees, and this is our steady state stability limit. I'll again revise this. The steady state stability limit of a particular circuit of a power system may be defined as maximum power at the receiving end of the circuit that can be transmitted without loss of synchronous if the load is increased in very small steps. Okay, this is our figure 5 is vector diagram of our fourth figure, vector diagram of circuit 4. The current vector is drawn horizontally. Consequently, the Ix drop are drawn vertically. The several voltage vectors radiating from point O differ by appropriate Ix drop. You can see here, okay. E1, V1, V2, E2. Okay, it is differ. Okay, there is certain angle in between E1 and E2. There is angle 90 degrees. Okay. In order to represent condition at the steady state stability limit, the diagram must be drawn so that V1 and V2 have their assigned values and so that E1 and E2 are 90 degree apart. Furthermore, the several Ix drop must be proportional to the corresponding reactances since current I is same in all reactances for series circuit. You can see here, current is same. So, this Ix drop is proportional to the value of reactances. Okay, so this is drawn. Now we'll see step by step how to draw this Clark diagram. Okay, as I told, we have drawn current, we have considered current as a reference. Now this we are starting from the receiving end. This is our E2, then V2, then V1, then E1. Okay, so this is Ix2, Ixe and Ix1. So we are starting from the receiving end. Okay, we are starting from receiving end and moving to the sending end. Okay, so first drop will draw as Ix2, second drop will Ixe, third drop is Ix1. Okay, so we'll see. This is Ix2, then IXE, and then IX1. Okay, now here ABDE, okay, C is drawn perpendicular to this line, okay, that we'll see later on, okay. So A is at header, or it is at head end of E1, okay, B at head end of V1, okay. So we'll see here it will be, here it will be A, here it will be B, here it will be D, here it will be E, okay, here it will be E. It is V2, it is E2, it is our E2, okay. V2 is at D, V1 is at B. Let's check. V2 at D and V1 at B. V1 at B, V2 at D. Okay. Now, here, our first step is over. Lay off segment IX1, IX2 and IXE starting from this end. Okay. So, just I will take one example. Suppose we are having x1 as 0.6, x2 as 0.2, and xe as 1, okay, xe as 1, okay, this we have. So according to this, we have to choose a scale. According to this, 1 centimeter is equal to 0.1 unit. Okay, 1 centimeter is equal to 0.1 unit. So IX2 will be, this will be our 2 centimeter. Okay, this IXE is 1, means it's one unit. So it is, according to this, it will be 10 centimeter. This will be our 0.6 centimeter. This will be our 6 centimeter. Okay, that means 10 plus 6 plus 2 means total 18 centimeter. Total 18 centimeter. Okay, now second step is draw a semicircle. Draw a semicircle using IX as a diameter. So definitely at 9 centimeter you can draw a semicircle. Okay, this is our second step. Now third step is locus. This is very important step. Locus of V1 divided by V2. What is this V1 divided by V2? Okay, in your example, V1 is given, V2 is given. If it is given, V1 is given, definitely it will be given. V1 or V2 is given. If it is infinite bus, then it is 1 per unit. Okay, then V2 is equal to, then it will be 1 per unit. Suppose we are taking just example, V1 is 1.1 and V2 is 1. Okay. So this we know. Now this our third step is locus of V1 and V2. Third step is locus of, I will change pin, okay, I will change locus of V1 and V2. This we have to draw, okay. I will just revise these steps. Lay off segment IX1, lay off segment IX1, this is IX1, lay off segment IX1. Lay off segment IX1, IXE, IXE and IX2 along a straight line, making them proportional to the given values of X1, XE and X2 respectively to any convenient scale, with I in bracket X1, XE and X2, IX as a diameter, construct a semicircle. This step already we have over. We have completed this step. This is our construct a portion of locus of ratio V1 by V2. Okay, and this constant ratio. This ratio should be constant. This ratio should be constant. Okay. So here it should be, if this V1 is equal to V2, then it is completely perpendicular bisector of Ix. Okay. If V1 is not V2, then it will not. Okay. That's it for now. Okay. This is our third step, and this is very important step. V1 by V2 will remain constant. Okay. Suppose V1 by V2 is remain constant. In our example, if it is given as V1 is 1.1 and V2 is 1. Okay. So this 1.1 will remain constant. Okay. Now you can change value of V1, V2 while this ratio 1.1 will remain constant. You can change value of V1 and V2. If you take 5.5 divided by 5, it will be 1.1. 8.8 divided by 8, it will be 1.1. So definitely that ratio should remain constant. Now coming back to our Clark diagram, so this ratio will be, this V1 by V2 is 1.1 should remain constant, as we have considered this ratio should be constant. Now you can, first point is 1.1, second point you can consider 5.5 divided by 5, third point you can consider 8.8 divided by 8. Okay, like this, that means 2 point inside the circle and 2 point outside the circle. Okay, so how to draw? Now first point is V1 1.1 and V2 1. Okay, now we have scale 1 centimeter equal to 0.1 unit, 1 centimeter equal to 0.1 unit. So V1 will be 11 centimeter and V2 will be 10 centimeter. So head at, we have to take bisector one head at this point, and you have to cut an arc. Okay, with radius, that magnitude you have to take as 11 centimeter. With V2 as the center or head, you have to draw another arc having measurement or having length 10 centimeter. Okay, you will get one point. Okay, suppose this is our first point. Now second point you have to draw, third point you have to draw, fourth point you have to draw, considering heads of V1 and V2. You can change this V1 and V2. 5.5 centimeter divided by 5, 2 point inside the circle, 2 point outside the circle, 8.8 divided by 8. You have to draw an arc, okay, with head V1 and B and D. Okay, so now this point is our center. Now from this you can have to draw E1, V1, V2, E2. E1 is perpendicular bisector of this Ix drop line. Okay, this is our EM. Our third step is over. Now fourth step is very important. Okay, fourth step is very important. Okay, the intersection of this locus with semicircle point, we have drawn this fourth step already. We have covered this fourth step, third step. The scale of diagram is set by specified values of V1 and V2. This is important, fifth one. Okay, we'll see this step, that is fifth step. Okay, we'll see this fifth step coming to our Clark diagram. Here suppose this is our E1, V1, V2 and E2. Now this V2 we have to measure. This V2 in terms of centimeter we have to measure. If suppose in measurement you got this as 8 centimeter or 8.1 centimeter. We'll take random figure. 8.1 centimeter. Okay. This V2 has 8.1 centimeter. And if suppose V2 is infinite bus, so this will be 1. Na? This will be 1 per unit. So now this you have to convert according to this. This we have to convert into units. So V2 will be 0.81 units. Okay. It, V2 will be 0.8 units. Okay. So now you have to calculate a scale. How to calculate scale? for 0.81 unit, it is showing 1 per unit, because V2 is given, it is infinite bus, it is 1 per unit. Okay, so this 0.81 unit of scale is giving you 1 per unit of hold. So 1 per unit of scale is will show how much unit of hold. That means you have to divide 1 divided by 0.81. okay, this will be our scale, this will be our scale, and that you have to multiply with the measured length. Okay, suppose you got this as, I don't know what is the value, this may be 0.2, this may be 0.21, whatever it may be. Okay, this is suppose 0.21. If suppose this is 0.21, then this 0.21 will be our scale, will be our scale, because this 0.83 unit of length, 0.81 unit of length is showing 1 unit of hold. Okay, I will again highlight this. 0.81 unit of scale is showing 1 unit of voltage. Okay, 0.81 unit of length is showing 1 unit of hold. So this, because we have to convert this, the values we are getting is in terms of centimeter, that you have to convert into voltage scale. So the scale is, this is our scale, 1 divided by whatever value you are getting. Suppose here you got 0.8182. What is this 0.81 or 82? This is measured length of V2. This is measured length of V2 in terms of centimeter. I am highlighting this. Look here. This is measured length of this V2. Okay. This you have to divide. Okay. So it is 0.21. Okay. So this is our scale is 0.21. okay, so E1 you have to measure, multiply with the scale. E2 we have to measure, multiply with the scale. E1 again you have to convert it into unit and then multiply with the scale. Okay, so coming back, the scale having been found, the power can be calculated. The two simple ways we are having, two simple way method for calculating power, P is equal to E1 into X, and second is P is equal to EM into I. As I told, we can directly draw perpendicular bisector from O to IX drop line, and that is your EM into I. Okay. This is about our Clark diagram. In next lecture, or I will upload video on graph paper how to draw this Clark diagram. But before that, you have to remember steps. First step is lay of segment IX, that is IX1 plus IX2 plus IXE. Okay, then draw a semicircle. Then third point, locus of V1 and V2, and this is constant, the ratio should remain constant. Then you have to draw E1, V1, V2, E2, and then fifth, find out scale. And then last is find out steady state stability limit, P max, by E1 by E2 into X or EM into I. E1 you have calculated from the scale, E2 you have calculated from the scale, X you know, so you can find out steady state stability limit of a system. This is our revision for the this we have revised what is how to draw the Clark diagram. This is very important. Thank you very much.